And you know what he told me? My best friend told me, baby, you're crazy. You got one of those things. This is pyramid. This is, man, I can't believe they got you. They got you. And I remember my doubt went up and my disappointment hurt me. So here's what happens. It took me a week to recover from that disappointment. And then I made my next call. But my success and your success and the velocity that you build this business will depend on your ability to recover from disappointment to disappointment. So it took me a week to recover. I made my next call. And I got another, one of the friends told me that this is a pyramid, this is not gonna work. Those things never work, David. And guess what? Disappointment. Now, it took me 4 days to recover. So my disappointment recovery went in. And then I did it again. And then it went to 3 days. And then again, it went to 2 days. Finally, today, my recovery is 0.05 seconds. That's what you have to do. You have to get from disappointment to disappointment. Okay, so getting out of your comfort zone. Number one, it starts with you finding your reason why. There's a story that goes about two tribes. One lived in the high in the mountains. The other one lived in the low, underneath the mountains. And they were always, for thousands of years, they existed, and they were always in battle. They were always at war. In one of the battles, the tribe that lived on top of the mountain kidnapped a baby. And then all the warriors from the lowland tribe got together and they said, we're going to rescue this baby. We're going to do this. And they went, they proceeded to go up the mountain to rescue the baby. But something happened. It was either too slippery. It was either too cold. It was too rocky. It was too, they couldn't find a way. They found a dead end. They just couldn't do it. 2 weeks passed by. Finally, the warriors came down from the mountain defeated. A couple of days passed by now. And they see a figure coming down the mountain. And what they notice is a woman carrying a child. And it was the actual mother of the baby, carrying her own baby. And the warriors were so, they were blown away. They were like, how did you do this? We, the best warriors, couldn't do this. How did you do it? And she looked at them intensely. She said, it wasn't your baby. You see, you have to find your own baby here. Kayani has to be the baby of you. So that comes from your why. Understanding what is it that motivates you. What is it that's going to force you to go through the valleys, to swim the oceans, to climb the mountains, to cross the desert. What's going to be your motivation? And that is the biggest thing. If you can get anything out of this weekend, let me share with you. Identify your why. Identify what's going to be your baby. What's going to be your motivation. Here's another one. After you do that, now you have to back it up with your daily activities. There's a Bible verse that says, faith without works is dead. So you can hope all you want, but if you don't do something about it on a daily basis and you don't have a daily activity plan, nothing's gonna happen. My mentor used to tell me, David, this discipline without action, or action in dreams without discipline in action, is the beginning of delusion. So don't have that delusion that it's gonna happen for you by you just thinking about it. You gotta do something on a daily basis, and you gotta start your day already with the intention of doing things. And I have our organization, we have what's called income bringing activities, AIBA. And I actually keep track of my income bringing activities. These are activities that produce income. Because there's a lot of stuff that we can do, right? There's actually a lot of stuff. But there's only about half a dozen things that produce income. What are these? Well, these are the things that produce a customer, or the things that produce a new business partners so they can acquire even more customers. So that's your daily activity. So how do you build your mindset? Number one, you gotta realize your potential. You gotta realize who you really are. But it's hard to sometimes realize our own potential, because we start looking at where we're at in life. And we start thinking, we get into what is called a fixed mindset. And we start thinking that because we're adding life, this is where we're going to be for the rest of our lives, don't we? So what do we do here? Well, you got to realize your potential. You see, my mentor said to me, David, you cannot change where you're at overnight. That you cannot do. But you got to realize what you can change is the direction or where you're heading overnight. That you can do. And you can always reinvent yourself. One of the biggest aha moments for me was that I had the ability to reinvent myself. Before this business, I didn't have the business disciplines. I didn't have the business knowledge. But guess what I did? I reinvented myself. I started acquiring the disciplines. And it didn't happen overnight, but yes, I changed the direction where I was heading overnight. And anybody can do that. That is one of the most wonderful experiences we can have, because realize that you're not a tree, you're not a dog, you're not a rock, you're a human being. You can change however you want to change. If you want your next 5 years to be completely different than your past 5 years, you can choose to do that. And that's exciting, ladies and gentlemen. That's very exciting. So how do you do that? Well, you got to take massive action. You gotta take action now. When is the best time? Now. Now is the best time to take action. Don't wait. Don't wait for conditions to be perfect. Ladies and gentlemen, there will never be a time where conditions will be perfect for any of us. You gotta start stepping to your power today and start taking action today. In fact, some of you here are gonna take this literally. And here's what you're gonna do. After this event, you're gonna be calling everybody up. And this event produces the most incredible opportunity for every single one of you. Because I remember after my first event, I was calling people. I was calling everybody, even people that I already spoke to before. I called them up and I was like, John, you're not gonna believe it. I am in the Philippines, Manila, and you know that Kayani thing I was telling you about 6 months ago? This is so much bigger than anything I ever thought. We really gotta sit down and talk. That right there is this event produces an opportunity for you to create excitement in your invitation. So take massive action. You also gotta visualize the results. Anything that happens in life was first thought. This building was first a thought. Someone visualizes that chair you're sitting in was first a thought. Was visualizing any speaker that you see up here was their first visualizing themselves up here, and then they were able to achieve it. And finally, you got to build certainty and belief. But how does that come? That comes from understanding your potential. You see, if you understand the potential and you believe that your potential in Kayani is big, is massive, guess what happens? You take massive action. Massive action produces massive results. Massive results reinforces the belief that you could do it, that you're right, your potential is unlimited. So what the opposite is also true, isn't it? If you believe that your potential in Kayani is small, are you going to take massive action or little action? Little action, aren't you? Little action produces little results. Little results reinforces the belief that you're right. You were right. I knew I couldn't do this. And guess what happens? And then you have even little more action. And little more action gives you little results. Little results. And then it becomes a downward spiral. But the opposite is true. When you believe in your potential, when you believe that you can really do this, it's game over, guys. Let me tell you, when you have 100% confidence in this opportunity, it's game over. It shows up in everything that you do. It shows up in the way you walk. It shows up in your demeanor. It shows up in the way you stand up. The way you approach people about this business. It shows up in everything that you do when you have 100% belief in your potential to go diamond in Kayani. But so it starts with you understanding. Everybody stand up. Stand up for me.
Yeah.
Stand up. Stand up. Come on, stand up. All right, everybody put your hand in your heart. And say, my potential is unlimited. And unknown. My potential is unlimited. And unknown.
And unknown.
That is so cool. And this is what you have right now. No longer are we allowed to complain. See, I received a call not too long ago from a friend of mine who is not in the business, complaining. Complaining about his life, complaining about things. And I remember telling him, bro, don't complain about what you allow. Because we are in complete control of our choices. You're in complete control of what input goes in here. If I can give you one bit of advice, what's your thoughts? Guard your mind of what goes in there. Be careful of who you hang around with. It's so important to understand this. See, my mentor said to me, David, you become the average of the five people you hang around the most. So you always want to make sure you're averaging up. That's why I read my Bible. Because I'm hanging out with me. And I want to average up. Does that make sense? So regard your mind and watch who you hang around with. It's so key. Because you might think that it's not a big deal, but the reality is we will never let somebody push us off course. But you might let someone nudge you, of course. And before you know it, you're in a completely different place. Before you know it, 2, 3, 5 years pass by. And you're having the bank account you don't want, living in the house that you don't want, having the relationship that you don't want. But it didn't happen overnight. It happened little by little. One of my favorite quotes is a quote by Buddha. He says, little by little, a person becomes evil. Like a pot of water is filled by drops of water. And little by little, a person becomes good. Like a pot of water is filled by drops of water. Everything happens little by little. Understand that. How do you get a team of 5,000 people? You sponsor your first person. That's how you do it. One person at a time. How do you get a team of 25,000 people? Here's how you do it. It starts with one person. One person at a time. Did you guys know that if there was a piece of paper big enough to fold 50 times, 50, a piece of paper, did you guys know that the width of that paper, how tall would it be? The width of that paper would be from Earth to the moon. That's the law of exponential growth. It happens. Well, how did that happen? It happens one fold at a time. And if you fold the paper one more time, you actually go from Earth to the sun and back. That's the law of exponential growth. Some of you are wondering, sitting back there, will this ever happen for me? That's what you're wondering. Let me tell you, I was that person back there, sitting, wondering, will this ever happen for me, God? And I want to share with you, if that's you, let me tell you, it will happen for you. Believe it. See yourself doing this. See yourself on stage. See yourself serving other people. The secret to success was given to us 2,000 years ago, when on a sermon in the mountain, when a wise man says to walk a mile, you go too. You got to become a servant leader. So my question to you is, are you ready to serve?
Yes.
Let me find out one more time. Are you ready to serve?
Yes.
Are you ready to serve?
Yes.
One more time. Are you ready to serve?
Yes.